For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Analysis Chart from your Sample Files folder. Notice that there's no indication anywhere on this worksheet where the page will break when printed. Excel will show you where the page breaks are, but it only does that after you've either entered Page Layout View or Page Break Preview View and then returned to Normal View. And it will also do this after you've printed a worksheet. Let's demonstrate this in action. I'm going to click the Page Layout View button at the bottom right of the screen. And then I'll click back onto the Normal View. And now you can see where the page will break, indicated by dotted lines. I can see both horizontal page breaks and vertical page breaks. Now it's possible that on your machine you won't see any dotted lines, and that's because somebody may have switched them off. Like so many features in Excel, Microsoft has given users the ability to switch this feature off, though I can't imagine why anybody would want to. But if you don't see the dotted lines, somebody has done just that on your machine. To bring the dotted page break lines back, click File at the top left of the screen, then Options on the left-hand menu bar, then Advanced on the left-hand menu bar, and then scroll down until you see Display Options for this worksheet. And notice there's an option to Show Page Breaks. It's important that this option is checked. And if you check the option and then click the OK button, you should then see the dotted lines on your worksheet indicating where the page breaks are. I can see that there's a problem with the page break on this worksheet. The vertical page break is slicing off the left-hand side of the chart. If I move to Page Layout View by clicking the Page Layout icon on the bottom right of the screen, I can see this happening. Part of the chart is appearing on the left-hand page and part is appearing on the right-hand page. I'm going to solve this problem now by manually inserting a vertical page break just to the left of column E. To do that, I'll first return to Normal View, and then I'll scroll to the top of the page and click in cell E1. Now it's important that you click in row 1 and not any other row, because if you clicked in a different row, you'd insert two page breaks, a horizontal page break above the active cell and a vertical page break to the left of the active cell. But by clicking in cell E1, we'll just insert a vertical page break to the left of cell E1. So I'll now click Page Layout on the ribbon and in the Page Setup group Breaks and then Insert Page Break. And when I click, notice that a solid grey line has appeared to the left of column E, indicating the new position of the vertical page break. When you see a solid line rather than a dotted line, you know that the break was manually inserted rather than automatically added by Excel. Let's confirm that the page will now print correctly. I could do this using the Page Layout View, but I'll do it using a Print Preview this time. So I'll click the File tab on the ribbon, then Print from the left-hand menu bar. And if I move to the last page in the printout, you can see that the chart is now printing correctly. I'll now click the Back button to return to the worksheet. Now let's look at inserting a horizontal page break manually. I can see that row 78 displays the first sale for November 2007. For presentational reasons, you might want November's sales to begin on a new page, so you need to insert a page break above row 78. I'm going to click in cell A78. Now it's important that you click in column A, otherwise both a horizontal and vertical page break would be inserted to the left of and above the active cell. Now I'll click Page Layout and in the Page Setup group Breaks and insert Page Break. And you can see that a solid grey line has now appeared above the active cell, indicating that row 78 will be the first row printed on a new page in the printout. I'll now confirm that this worksheet will print correctly, with row 78 on a new page. I think this time I'll do it using Page Layout View. So I click the Page Layout icon, and now I'll scroll to row 78. And you can see that row 78 is indeed beginning on a new page. I'll now return to Normal View by clicking the Normal icon. So now I know how to insert page breaks. How do I remove a page break when I've changed my mind? Let's imagine that I want to change my mind about that page break above row 78. I first need to position the active cell so that the top of the active cell is touching the grey line. In other words, the page break. Now it's important that I don't click in cell E78, because then the active cell would be touching both the horizontal page break and also the vertical page break to the left of column E. And I don't want to remove the vertical page break. So I'll click in, say, cell C78. Then I'll click Page Layout on the ribbon, then Breaks, and then Remove Page Break. And the horizontal page break is now removed. And the printout will no longer break to show row 78 on a new page. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Sales Analysis Chart 1. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed lesson 7.5, Insert, Delete, and Preview Page Breaks.